Robert Greenberger has written dozens of novels, short stories, and novellas, many of them taking place in the Star Trek universe. For him, the idea of becoming a writer started with one of the greatest heroes of all time.
Superman. I was asthmatic as a child, and every year could always be counted on missing days of school for bronchitis. When I was six, my mother brought me a comic book, a Superman comic, to keep me occupied while I was in bed, and I was captivated. And then I discovered the George Reeves TV series in rerun on New York's WPIX and was just like, wow. And I liked the idea that he was working for a major metropolitan newspaper, so that was my starting point. I wanted to be a journalist like Clark Kent.
His love of comics led him to work for both the major comic book companies at different times, having been a manager editorial operations at DC and director publishing operations at Marvel.
They're lively, they're creative, they're chaotic, but they're also offices. I mean, where you've got hierarchies and structures, and DC, owned by Time Warner, obviously was a major piece of a machine, but there were the rules and regulations to follow, and you know, a little more corporately dressed up than the Marvel, which was always a little more carefree. And the company, when I was there, was coming out of the bankruptcy, so things were still a little shaggy, but the owner, Ike Perlmutter, was making sure every nickel went appropriately towards the bottom line, towards the company, and not like at lavish parties or meals out or the like. In the case of growing up with Superman and Batman comic books and then working at DC Comics, I was steeped in the lore. So when DC and Random House cut the deal for the encyclopedias, I seemed to be a logical go-to guy and did the essential Batman encyclopedia by myself. And then stepped in to help Marty Pascoe finish up the Superman encyclopedia, which was a joy to work with an old buddy.
Having worked as an editor for years, Greenberger has a different foundation when he sits down to write.
It means I'm very conscious of story structure. I'm also very conscious of deadline. But as a writer, it's like, you know, now I've developed all these muscle memory and skills and experiences that I draw from both the writing side and the editorial side of the table.
Greenberger also believes in writing and writing often and dismisses talk of writer's block.
I don't believe in writer's block. It usually means you've hit a point in your thinking process where your brain has to process it a little bit more. And a good writer knows when to just walk away, take a walk, walk the dog, see a movie, go, you know, do something, and let your mind work on it. Most writers I know have multiple projects, so if they hit a wall with project one, they'll let it percolate in the back of the brain and go to project two. Or they'll answer email, or they'll do something to just free things up. But staring at the blank screen or the blank page, I don't believe in that.
A Maryland resident, Greenberger has been active at the Shore Leave Science Fiction Convention for years.
It has grown. It's been great because it's like a second family. When I relocated down here 2 years ago, it was like I already had a network of friends and associates to be with, which has been great. Shore Leave has grown nicely, but it maintains a family feel. People come year after year, and all of a sudden you have second and third generations growing up at the conventions, which has been great to see.
Shore Leave will be held August 7th through 9th at the Hunt Valley Inn. Fans can meet many of their favorite science fiction and fantasy actors, including John Barrowman from Arrow and Jamie Murray and Tony Curran from Defiance. Among the other writers besides Greenberger are New York Times bestselling author Kirsten Beyer, Michael Jan Friedman, and T.J. Perkins. Details about Shore Leave can be found at shoreleave.com.
If you like the TV shows the guests are there to speak about, if you enjoy reading and writing and talking to writers, or you want to take workshops to learn how to write, you like art shows, you like costuming, you like hard science, we have scientists there, you like music, you like silly stuff, you just like community. Surely that offers all of that. It's a nice 3-day getaway to be with like-minded people. Certainly, with the diversity of the shows available on TV and movies today, there is so much to talk to peers about, so much to hear, the various panel discussions, books to buy from the you know, nearly 4 dozen authors are going to be there that you may not have experienced before, or just to hear the celebrities talk about their experiences, meet them, get a photo. It's a good time.